This is part 33 of Azure tutorial. In our previous video, we discussed what is Azure API Management service and the benefits it provides. In this video, we'll discuss how to create a new instance of Azure API Management service. In the Azure portal, on the homepage, as you can see, I have API Management Services icon here. If you don't find this icon on the homepage, you know what to do. Using this search text box, search for API Management Services. So let's create a new instance of API Management Services. Now, just like any other resource in Azure, first select your Azure subscription, a resource group, region where you want this resource to be created, and then a name. I'm going to name this resource Employee API Management. This name is very important because it has to be unique and can't be changed later. Remember, Azure API Management Service is made up of three main components: Azure Portal, Developer Portal, and the API Gateway. Both the Developer Portal and the API Gateway uses this name. So by default, the API Gateway URL will be Employee API Management dot azure-api.net, and the developer portal URL is again Employee API Management dot developer dot azure-api.net. You can use your own custom domain if you want to, maybe something like api.prajimtech.com. Next, organization name. This name is also important because it is this name that is used in the developer portal and in any notification emails that you get. Next, administrator email. It is this email address to which API Management will send all notification emails. Finally, pricing tier. If you want to explore all the pricing tiers, then click on this Learn More link. I'm going to stick with this developer pricing tier and then click Review and Create. As you can see, validation passed, and for Azure to create an instance of API Management for us, all we need to do is click this Create button. Now, Azure may take 15 to 20 minutes to create an instance. This is because it has to create the developer portal for us. Now, while Azure is creating the instance for us, we don't have to stay on the screen. We can even shut down our machine if we want to. Upon successfully creating the instance, we will receive an email notification on the specified administrator email address. Remember, we specified goodvenkat@gmail.com as the administrator email. So upon successfully creating the API Management instance, I will receive a notification on this email address. So there is no need to stay on this screen while Azure is creating the instance of API Management for us. Now, I'm actually not going to click Create because I already have an instance of API Management service created. So let's go back to the homepage and then navigate to the available API Management service instances. Notice I named it EMP API MGMT, short for Employee API Management. Let me click on this. At the moment, we are on the overview blade, and on the right here, we have both the developer portal and the gateway URLs. And here is the interesting bit. Notice in both the URLs, we have the name of our API Management service instance, EMP API MGMT. On the left, we have this menu item, APIs, and when I click on that, at the moment, we have just one sample API here, Echo API. In our upcoming videos, we'll discuss how to publish our own APIs and manage them effectively using this API Management service instance. That's it in this video. Thank you for listening.